Alright, it's been a while since I made a video. Just been busy and haven't been up here faithfully every weekend. Other stuff going on, but what's going on? Nothing's really changed in here, but I don't know where I left off on the last video. You know, we did finish reframing all of this. I did put the new pipe in, and that's all going up to the new valve. All of that's been completed. We did wind up having to tear out the bathroom floor and gut the bathroom. That's what all of this is. Mold tough sheetrock. Because the light's gone. So let me get the clip lamp. We'll do our best with this. So I tore out the original floor. The original floor broke. And it was about 2 inches of tile and thin set on top of 1/2 inch plywood. I went back down with 2 layers of 3/4 inch plywood. One would have probably sufficed, but I'd already bought the wood, so I laid the second layer. This floor, you could park a Buick on it. It's not going anywhere. Well, I guess it's dependent on the rafters, but this floor is solid. The lower layer, I nailed along the joist every 3 inches. Top layer every 6, except for a few areas I wanted to reinforce. I got the brass flange, sweated off the pipe. I had to trim the copper waste stack there. It's 3-inch copper. I had to trim that down because this floor is still sitting about 3/4 of an inch. Well, what the heck, we had 2.5 before and now we got 1.5, so this was still an inch lower than the old floor when all was said and done. So, and I wound up cutting that with a hacksaw blade held in my fingers since it was so close to the floor before I laid the second layer. And I pulled it off. It wasn't easy, but I got it pretty even. And I got that sweated back on, and I got a couple of screws in there. So that's a nice level surface. I don't think we'll have any more sealing issues with the toilet. I don't know if you can see, and this is something that's kind of funny that happened to us. When I redid that back part underneath the tub, I bought my wood from Home Depot. And I bought 3/4 inch plywood, and I bought 2x8 joists. Well, when I redid the rest of the floor in here, the joist I replaced, I bought from the local lumber supply around the corner, as I did the plywood. Well, the 2x8 joists were cut differently. So I wound up with, not only is the plywood was a little bit thicker from the lumber yard than from Home Depot, but the joists were about, at least 3/4 of an inch taller, the 2x8s I got from the lumber yard, and the 2x8s at Home Depot were selling. So I wound up with a higher floor through here than what's back there. Now, I've got it, as you might be able to see here, there's a bit of a ledge, but this is going to line up right against the tub, and it's a size perfect. In fact, I had the tub in here when I cut it in, and I was able to get it back out to do some other work, but this will work fine. It's just that this floor is almost an inch higher over here, and the floor actually raises a bit going up to that ledge because one of the new joists I put in right next, so I'd have something to nail the edge of the floor to, was that much higher than the 2x8 from, Home Depot. I mean, that's really why we have that ledge there, is the difference in the cut in the lumber. I don't know what Home Depot does. I'll have this on an extension cord. There's the valve, the Simmons valve. Everything's done. I finished it all today. It's level, it's even. I had to go back and trim up one side of the supply lines down to get it to line up correctly. But all of that is fine. I took the drain pipe. I got it sweated off of here. I have to go find a new piece. It was all rusted. I can probably use the L again, but the piece that was sticking through the wall was just, you know, it was a lost cause. And I've got the last little piece for the tub I got out. As you can see, there's no more tile in here. We gutted the whole thing when we took the floors out. And I ripped all the sheetrock out. We're going to put all the green rock in here. There's really no reason to try to... They had so many layers of wallpaper and paint on the old stuff, there was no reason to try to salvage it. So the next thing to do is do a final cleanup in here, make sure we got everything vacuumed up real good. And I'm going to hang the sheetrock around the tub. Actually, I can't. Well, I'm going to have to bring the tub in and then hang sheetrock, but that's okay. Because I'm going to hit, once I close this wall in, that's it. But I'm going to cripple those studs there, and we'll be okay with that. And I got to patch the ceiling up there from when they put the AC drain in. And I got to get up in here, and I think I'm going to go right on the other side of this stud. I know it's a little close to the AC vent, but I don't want to get too far over towards the shower area. But I got a heat exhaust, not a heat, I think I got a vent and a light, but a proper exhaust vent for this bathroom. So I got to get that mounted in the ceiling, in the attic, and all of that good stuff. And of course I'll come through here and replace this box, put a GFI in here, get rid of this old switch, and get all of this sheet rocked in, and then maybe I can start. I'm going to leave the other side of this wall open, because the attic for the living area is right on the other side of this insulation. But when I start rewiring, I'll still be able to drop some stuff down to do the kitchen circuits properly. And I'm going to at least isolate this circuit, you know, and dedicate it to this bathroom. It shouldn't be too hard to do. That's what junction boxes are for. Well, as you can see, there's my little halogen lamp, because that's the attic in there. Yeah, there's a lot of rewiring to be done up there. Right now there's the cabinet for the bathroom and the toilet. And that's about it. This is the main stuff that I've been working on for the last few weeks. You know, this has mainly been it. This getting this bathroom back in shape. Now that it's structurally sound, you know, we can go forward. And I still gotta come back and get some floor patch and compound and prepare this for the vinyl. Because I decided I'm gonna put vinyl down in here. But that's about it. Nothing else to really report at the moment. It's been the lion's share of our efforts lately. Of course, this is the vanity out of the bathroom. Refinish this. Get it cleaned up. Strip the overpainting off the front. You know, get some layers of paint down where we can repaint it with some enamel and it'll look decent again. These are all hand built Douglas fir. Alright, can't think of anything else, so we'll see y'all next time.